Hello everyone, I am Vidhin Chitkara. So welcome back to another video on open source and Google Summer of Code. So in the last session, we saw what open source and Google Summer of Code were all about. So now in this particular video, we will learn how to make an open source contribution. So what we'll have is a hands-on session on how to make a contribution. And in subsequent videos, we will see how to make a proposal. So do subscribe to our channel for all the regular updates. Okay guys, so let's get started. So what we are currently seeing is pretty much how an open source repository looks like. So there's a bunch of sections that are there. And let's have a look at them one by one. So we have a section which has a few files. So in real case scenario, we'll have a lot more files, and generally they'll be code files. So we currently have names.txt and readme.md, and this basically section contains all the code files and all the code base essentially, right? Apart from this, there is a section of readme.md. So this section contains all the instructions about how to contribute to this repository and what actually this repository is all about. So this gives all the instructions about the repository, right? Apart from that, there are two more sections which are very important. So the first one is issues. So the issues section contains a list of issues, and by issues we mean that all the bugs, the features, and all the additions we need to that are needed in this code base. So a list of issues is there. From these issues, we'll be picking one of them, and we'll be using that to make our first contribution, right? And apart from the issues, there are pull requests. So in real case scenario, there will be hundreds or 200 or thousands of contributors. So this pull request tab contains all the code changes of each individual contributor, right? So let's now quickly jump on to the instructions and see how to make the contributions, right? So we'll jump on to how to contribute. So the first step it's saying is to fork this repository. So what do we mean by forking this the repository? So by forking, we mean that we need to make a duplicate of this repository. So currently this repository is on this organization named Vidit Coding Ninjas, and what we need to do is copy this project into our own GitHub profile, right? So if I see here, I do not find any project named contribution demo here, right? So what I need to do is I need to clone this project over into my own profile, right? So it usually takes around a few seconds. So let's wait for that. Right, it's done. So let me check over here by refreshing. So yeah, I can see contribution demo over here, right? I can see contribution demo over here. Right, so let's move on to the next step. So second step, it's asking me to clone the project. So by cloning the project, we mean that from the copied repository, we need to download this, download all these files into our local machine, right? So how do we do that? We need to go to this clone code button. We need to copy this URL which it's giving me, and I'll quickly move on to my code editor. And I have a folder named demo OS, and it's currently empty. Now I'll quickly git clone. I'll do a git clone. So what this command does is it downloads all the files from this particular URL which we copied. Right, it's done. Now let's check the contents. Right, it has added a contribution demo folder. So let's cd into that. Now we can see that we now have the names.txt and readme.md files on our local machine, right? So we have successfully completed the second step, right? So let's move on to the third step. So it's asking me to choose an issue, make changes, and finally commit. So what's actually going on over here? So first of all, we need to choose an issue. So we had a list of issues over here. So let's go on to that. I view all the issues and I find that a good first timer issue is this: add a line to names.txt. So let's explore this. So what it wants me to do is to add the following line to names.txt file, right? So should I start working on this? No. First we need to check if anyone else is working on this, but it doesn't seem like anybody is working. So let's ask if I could work on this. So this could be a good way to ask. Let's wait for the approval. Well, I've got the approval. So let's start working on this, right? So let's quickly move to the code base. I'll open the contents in my code editor. Right, so it has opened these two files over here, right? So we have the contents over here. Now what we need to do is to make changes. We need to add this line to names.txt. But should we right away start? No. We first need to check which branch we are on. So by this command, we will check on which branch we are on. So we currently are on the main branch. So this, by convention, we do not make code changes to a main or a master branch or whichever branch the organization has specified, right? So the main branch is something which we won't be committing to, or we the changes will not be making. And what we'll do is we'll need to cut out a different branch from this main branch. So let's make a different branch. So what command I'm using: git checkout minus b and any name of the branch, let's say with it. Right, so let's now check the branch list. So yeah, a branch is made and we are currently on that branch, right? So the star indicates the current branch, right? So we are all set to make the changes. So let me copy this line directly, add this over here, save this, and now it's ready to be pushed, right? So let me check what's going on and what all are the changes. So using this git status command, we have a list of all those files which are modified or which are added to the code base, right? So now I need to make these changes ready to be pushed onto the cloned repository. So this command makes our changes ready to be pushed. So you can see that all the files which were modified are now turned into green. So now this is a signal that hey, you need to now, so this code is now ready to be pushed and you need to commit those changes. Now what I'll do is I'll write a command named git commit minus m with a commit message, which tells us what all these changes are all about. So I'll give a simple message like update names.txt. Right, so this is the actual command: git commit minus m and the commit message. So I quickly press enter. Right, so it has committed my changes, right? And it has shown me that one file was changed with two insertions, right? So now, since the changes are currently on my local machine, I need to push those changes to the cloned repository, right? So what I'll do is I'll write a command known as git push origin. And after that, the branch in which we made the changes, which was with it. Right. So it has pushed my changes to the branch named with it. Now let's go on to the cloned repository, which was this. And now it's showing me that with it has recent pushes less than a minute ago. This shows the branch, and this now shows me that a few changes were made a minute ago, right? So what we need to do now is to make the original repository aware that I need to make my changes merged into the original code base. So what I'll do is I'll create a pull request. So there's a simple method to compare and pull request. Right. So this shows all my changes, a diff of all my changes, and you can see that the title of the pull request, it has fetched from my commit message, which was update names or txt. But there was one thing which was missing. So we didn't read how to make a pull request, right? So let's quickly read. So it says that the commit message should be comprehensive and not have a message like minor changes or refactoring, etc., which I think we have accomplished, right? Second, the PR description, the pull request description, must include the issue number against which the PR is created. So, okay, let's do it. So the issue number is 1. So what we'll do is we'll add this issue number to the pull request. So let's quickly go on to this. Here's the pull request description. I'll write quickly closes hash and the issue number. So this has done some autocomplete work for me. Let me select this and I'll simply create a pull request. Right. So this is how we create a pull request. Now let's visit the pull request tab over here on the original code base, and we see that our pull request is already there. Right. Now we can see that my pull request title is appearing over here, and the pull request description is over here, and this gives a link to the issue we have created the pull request for. Right. So that's pretty much it on how to make a pull request. And apart from this, there are a few more commands which are frequently used in open source contributions. So some of those are git fetch and git rebase. So we'll add those to this video's description, and please explore on that, and they'll be very handy when we start making contributions, right? So we'll wait for this pull request to be merged, and finally we have made our first contribution, right? So that's it. Let's now look forward to our next video, which will most likely be on making a great proposal. So that's all from my side for this video. Right, thank you.
For new programming updates and videos, subscribe to Coding Ninjas channel.